Welcome to Hardcrest Stadium, birthplace of the Microhard Mutilators. Today's game brought to you by Microhard Crash and Burn Technologies. Yeah, this is going to be a bloody game. The teams are loading their weapons and sharpening their spikes. The Carolina Panzers battle the Microhard Mutilators. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's a beautiful day for NFL football, at least in the booth with the AC, personal servants, and blood shield. Hi, Grim Blitzrow here with you, along with my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Briggs. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing that little hottie who works in deep fry at the concessions.
He said how, not who, you idiot, even if you got the answer right.
And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. Well, as a quarterback, you have to take risks and just chuck. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And it's first and 10. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
First down and one. The defender touchdown! Down! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Actually, he does have some turkeys getting drafted on his backside from that bad burn he had last year.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. Second down and a lot. And the defense jumps off sides trying to mutilate the QB.
It's not how many times you fall, it's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline. First and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Does the QB know which team he's on? Oh, nice hit. I don't remember that being an officially sanctioned NFL rule. First and goal. The defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. First down and five.
Not one.
And he breaks away. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Second and three. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. With the brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. And he laterals the ball. Man, these guys like playing high-risk ball. And a hard run there picks up the first down. And it's first and ten.
Away from the pass marker? That's a good clue that something's not right.
Second down and 10. And the defense holds that pass play to only 2 yards. Third down and 8.
Way to keep the chains moving.
Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. And it's first and 10. They run it for a yard. Second down and 9. And the defense goes for the jugular and rushes to... And that unsportsmanlike play of the day brought to you by the good folks at Speedy's Drive-Thru Funeral Parlor Service, located just off the Beltway Exit 5. And it's first and 10. Nicely done. Picks up 3 on that pass play.
Ooh la la.
Second down and 7. And the ball is lateral to his teammate. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. Normally I don't advocate for changing the station, but for the sake of your eternal soul, I'd understand if you want to cut away during this ritualistic dance.
Grim? The crowd started chanting.
Why, yes, Yes, they did. We're free to go ahead and lock the announcer's booth until he's done dancing. And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and ten.
Hunt one, hunt two.
How do you like your defenses cooked? The ball carrier sent.
Nothing to blow a play, but to blow up on a play? Then it's the team. I should learn from this.
He's dead.
Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And it's first and ten. Says, I don't think so. Second down and 10.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Third down, and the punter is warming up. Oh, and he bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run. Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
First and ten.
Hunt one.
Full man, about a 6-yard gain.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And that'll be second down and four.
Hunt one, hunt two.
Call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. And it's first and ten. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
Second down and nine.
Hunt one.
And picks up maybe a deuce at most. Come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. And that'll bring up third down and seven. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty... If you get one more bullshit penalty, you get one more for free.
You'll also probably lose the game.
Yeah, just do the attack ref dirty trick.
That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
There's no reason to go, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Nice punt. Should move him back nice. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and 10. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about sharing with him. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. They might catch him.
Oh, you fat little Newton.
Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
And he picks up about 6 on the play. And that'll be 2nd, 10, and 4.
Hot one, hot two, hot three. Holy mother of mutant mayhem, he scored!
With moves like that, you know he's got a screw loose. Hey, can we get a handyman out there? Somebody drill? Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's 1st and 10. He picks up 5 on that play.
Said never hit a man when he's down. He's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
Second down and 5. Down and long. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt return. Boom! Holy smokes, he just killed that player with a cheap shot.
Yep.
That's why we love the NFL. And it's 1st and 10.
Hot one, hot.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a It's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
That's a 6-yard gain. And that'll be second down and four.
Hot one, hot two, hot, hot,
hot. And he gets 3 yards on that run. And that'll bring up third down and inches.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Leaving a wake of destruction in his path. And the offense is running low on running backs. They have only two left. They need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and ten.
Hot one. Hot.
Oh, with a punishing hit. And it's first and ten. And that's how you shock the monkey. Thunderclap. And the offense averts disaster. And that'll give him four more downs to punish the defense. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
And the defense is on his heels. The offense lost their last running back on the previous play. Next time the offense comes out on the field, they will have no running plays. And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
I don't know whose eyes the QB is using. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and ten. My friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
And with another pick, the QB says, I don't always throw interception like bricks his bowels. He is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Oh, with a brutal hit. Oh, you knew you were. we're going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
One, hot, two, eight.
I've had it. I'm running out of it. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and ten. He picks up 9 yards on that catch. And that'll bring up second and one. First down! He was not going to drop that. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the NFL. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brick's match stumping time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Trying to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The kicker's going to have to kick the ball just right so his team can recover it. You usually only talk about kickers when they win or lose games. Well, this guy just earned his paycheck, which is typically the amount the quarterback tips on dinner. And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. First down! Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. First and ten. The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. Well, this kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
And he came out of nowhere. And he's off to the races. Here comes the defense. He's at the 40. The 30. The 20. He's at the 10. Great shoestring tackle. At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries, makers of great killer products like Groundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. The third quarter is about to start as the teams take the field. This game has been one lopsided rout.
Yeah, football games are kind of like boobs. Big or small, they're both great. Except for when they're lopsided.
Okay, no, I can't. Come on,
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the NFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Second down and long.
Hot one, hot two.
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. It's a touchdown. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
It's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
He's at the 20, the 10, and he scores. Lost their last quarterback. Next time their offense comes out on the field, they will have to forfeit the game. Now, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. The Microhard Mutilators were soundly mutilated today and forfeit the game. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.